Hello everyone, I am Pawan. I am currently a graduate student at UT Austin. I work in the area of image and video processing. So in this brief presentation, I'll discuss some of the recent work which I've been associated with, which involves modeling temporal distortions that arise due to changes in frame rate. So I'll briefly begin with the introduction to the main problem we address in this work, followed by the motivation behind choosing this problem. Later, I'll discuss the proposed model, which is simply a combination of features from two different models, which are generalized entropic difference model and DMAF model. In the end, I'll discuss some of the experiments we conduct in order to evaluate the proposed model and provide some concluding remarks. The objective of this work is capturing the quality variations that arise due to changes in frame rate. A simple illustration is shown over here, where a video which has significant camera motion can be observed at 60 FPS. Since this is being viewed through Zoom, I guess there might be some additional artifacts that can be arising due to the Zoom thing. So pardon me for that. Viewing the same video at 24 FPS, we can observe that there exists a lot of significant temporal artifacts that were not present at the 60 FPS version. Key takeaway from this illustration is that the quality perceived can be a combination of both frame rate as well as compression distortions. Thus, the goal over here is to capture these artifacts that mainly arise due to changes in frame rate and compression distortions. The motivation behind choosing this problem is that the current state-of-the-art video quality assessment models provide less emphasis on temporal component, and temporal components play a key role in analyzing the quality variations that arise due to changes in frame rate. In fact, the most popular VMAF model just uses frame differences between the successive video frames. Additionally, frame rate dependent video quality assessment is quite challenging, as the effect of content is more pronounced, as can be observed in another illustration shown over here, where the video which has comparatively less motion associated with it can be viewed at 60 FPS. Viewing the same video at 24 FPS, we can observe that there does not exist that much of a quality difference when both of these videos are compared. Key takeaway from this illustration is that the effect of content and the presence or absence of camera object motion can be quite dominant when analyzing the video quality in terms of frame rate. The proposed model is just an extension of our previous work, where we had proposed a generalized entropic difference model to account for frame rate artifacts. In this work, we extend that to include the features from VMAP and GRID. And the motivation behind using this feature fusion model is to take the advantage of both of these models. VMAP has good performance when videos which have same frame rates are compared, while GRID has good performance when videos at different frame rates are compared. Thus, fusing features can result in more robust model which can work for both scenarios. Additionally, this fused feature set can give more emphasis on the temporal artifacts, which is quite absent in the current VQA models. In a couple of slides, I'll briefly describe the previous generalized entropic difference model as well as the VMAF model and how both these models are used in the current proposed model. GRID is derived from statistical deviations that are observed due to changes in frame rate. A simple illustration is shown over here, where a temporally bandpass filtered version at 60 FPS can be viewed, and the video is comparatively smooth. While viewing the same at 24 FPS, we can clearly observe the various types of distortions that arise due to change in the frame rate. So, based on this observation, the idea is quite simple. The first step is to temporarily bandpass filter each of these videos and calculate the entropies at a batch level. The entropies are calculated by assuming that the bandpass coefficients follow a generalized Gaussian distribution and neural noise model, which models imperfect perception. The last step is to compare the reference and the restarted entropies. However, simply comparing videos of different frame rates, entropies of different frame rates can be counterproductive as signal subsampling inherently modifies the entropy. Thus, taking the entropic difference just accounts for the frame rate change while ignoring the effects of compression. This we term as a frame rate bias of the entropy, and in order to remove this frame rate bias, we include additional signal which we term as pseudo-reference signal. Pseudo-reference video is just a temporarily subsampled version of the reference which has the same frame rate as the distorted version. The temporal grade index is defined as shown over here, which mainly has two important terms. The first is the absolute difference term, which measures the absolute difference between the distorted and the pseudo-reference entropies, and this mainly accounts for compression distortion. The ratio term involves the entropies of the reference and the pseudo-reference, and it acts as a weighting term, and it mainly depends on the frame rate of the reference and the distorted, and it's agnostic to the amount of compression present in the distorted version. Additionally, grid also has a spatial component in order to capture spatial artifacts. The spatial entropy is calculated in a very similar manner, but replacing the temporal bandpass filter by a spatial bandpass filter. The spatial bandpass filter which we use is local mean subtracted filter. Additionally, since the spatial bandpass filtering is done at each frame, there does not arise any bias due to the frame rate, and spatial grid is just the absolute difference between the reference and the distorted. This concludes the discussion on grid. Next, I'll discuss the video multi-method fusion. PMAF is just a combination of multiple elementary quality indices. It includes detail level metric, which captures the detail losses, and it has visual information fidelity, which measures image fidelity based on natural scene statistics. Since this is a video model, it also has temporal information to capture temporal component. It's just a Luma difference between the successive video frames. These features are then fed to a support vector regressor in order to map video features to quality. The proposed model, which we term as grid VMAF model, replaces the temporal information feature present in VMAF with grid features. The entire algorithm is described over here, where the DLM and VIF are calculated by considering the pseudo reference and the distorted video, while grid is calculated using all the three signals, the reference, the distorted, and the pseudo reference. The last step involves concatenating all these features in order to obtain the grid VMAP features. These features are then fed to a support vector regressor to learn mapping between the features and the quality. For this purpose, we evaluated it on the recently released live YouTube HFR dataset. The training is done by using 70% of the content present in the dataset, and the remaining is used for validation and testing. While training, we ensure that there exists no overlap between the contents. The next couple of slides, I briefly describe the experiment we conduct in order to evaluate the proposed model. The first experiment is to analyze the Spearman rank order correlation coefficient and Pearson linear correlation coefficient between the human opinion scores and the quality predicted by the grid VMAP as well as other VQA models. And from the table, we can observe that the grid VMAP has somewhat similar performance compared to that of grid. Another experiment we conduct is to evaluate the performance on each individual frame rate present in the HFR dataset. And you can observe that grid VMAP has quite superior performance when compared to grid as well as VMAP, especially in the lower frame rate region. Perhaps the best performance of live VQA, performance of grid VMAP is observed in generic VQA datasets, where three VQA datasets such as Live VQA, CSIQ VQA, and Live Mobile are analyzed. And from the table, we can observe that Grid VMAP performs both VMAP as well as Grid on Live Mobile and CSIQ VQA datasets, suggesting that the features are somewhat more generalizable than both VMAP as well as Grid, and as well includes more features that well account for temporal distortion. Some concluding remarks: a simple extension to the existing VMAP and Grid model was proposed in this work, which gives more emphasis on capturing temporal artifacts. It mainly combines the advantages of both the models, and from the experiments we observe that these features are more generalizable, works well on both high frame rate and as well as non-high frame rate VQA databases. Additionally, this model is motivated from perceptual and statistical principles. I would like to thank our collaborators from YouTube as well as YouTube for supporting this work. Thank you.